karst terrain that is thick limestone and dolostone rock units which have undergone significant amounts of erosion due to water form a spectacular array of unusual landforms worldwide. Yet, some of these karst terrain localities feature something below the surface, numerous caves. One of these localities can be found in central Kentucky, being known as the Mammoth Cave. Here, numerous caves go on and on below ground for dozens of miles, in addition to probably undiscovered caves which are forming right now. As a whole, the Mammoth Cave complex is the largest single cave system on the planet, containing 426 miles or 686 kilometers of known length. Largely protected in Mammoth Cave National Park, these caves are a spectacular sight for all to see. So, how do they form? The story of the Mammoth Caves began 330 million years ago when to the east of Kentucky were 10,000-foot-high Appalachian mountain range peaks, while the site of the eventual caves was covered by a vast ocean that encompassed the entire state which, as a whole, was south of the equator. In this ocean, millions of fish, corals, and hard-shelled creatures lived in temperate coral reefs along with now long-extinct trilobites and ammonites. As the creatures with hard parts died, they left behind their shells which, along with precipitated calcium carbonate from the ocean, created a thick layer of limestone. Over many millions of years, this created a thick layer of limestone which eventually totaled around 328 feet or 100 meters thick. The region eventually rose above sea level, and after more than 250 million years of geologic activity, the limestone became exposed on the surface as overlying younger rock units eroded away. Calcium carbonate, aka limestone, is a basic material which happens to be prone to partially dissolving when rainfall hits it, as average rainfall has a pH of around 5.7, meaning it is slightly acidic. Thus, when heavy rainfall affected the area, it caused weaker areas of the limestone to dissolve, forming cracks. These cracks then combined with the nearby movement and waters of the Green River beginning around 10 million years ago, causing large void spaces to develop and miniature underground passageways to form almost like miniature rivers. As these expanded over time, larger and larger caverns developed. As the Green River continued to carve away its surrounding rock, it caused the water table in the region to drop lower and lower. Thus, water soon drained into cracks in the bottom of the first level, allowing the prior process to repeat at a now lower water table, beginning the formation of a secondary cave layer. This process repeated for millions of years, with the process accelerating during the last ice age as dramatic climatic variations caused the water table to rapidly drop at a faster rate. In total, five layers were formed along with more than 400 miles of caves. Today, rainwater still seeps into all layers of the caves, and as it travels through cracks within the limestone, the acid picks up molecules of calcium carbonate. Some of this is then redeposited onto the roof of a cave as the water drips downward, forming a stalactite. The region where the water drops hit the ground in a consistent spot also have some calcium carbonate get left behind, forming stalagmites. When a stalactite and stalagmite combine, they form a column which stretches from the cave ceiling to the cave floor. Flowstone formations with a somewhat bumpy appearance form when water rich in calcium carbonate flowed along cave walls or the cave floor. A fourth fun feature you can find in these caves are cursed strands of gypsum crystals, which are an interesting sight to see. Thanks for watching. If you would like to request a specific topic, please leave a comment below. Additionally, I would like to thank this channel's patrons on Patreon and channel members on YouTube.